After a fall in her home, 78-year-old Bessie Owen says she just needed some help getting a ramp installed.
Instead, the longtime Detroit resident ended up being put under guardianship in the probate courts, where she was declared legally incapacitated.
7 investigator Heather Cataldo joins us now to continue her guardianship investigation, and this time with a look at a Wayne County case. Heather.
Well, Carolyn and Dave, when you're put under guardianship and conservatorship, you can no longer make any legal, medical, or financial decisions. That's why Bessie Owen says she wants to know why Adult Protective Services workers did that to her instead of helping her get what she really needed.
Bessie Owens needs a walker to get around, but she's still fiercely independent.
And I got other gadgets in here to help me remain independent as possible.
The 78-year-old struggles with osteoarthritis, but Bessie says she is more than capable of handling her own medical and financial affairs.
I think I should have some input into my life daily.
That's why the longtime Detroiter is furious that an Adult Protective Services worker petitioned the Wayne County Probate Court last May to place Bessie under guardianship and conservatorship.
Did you have any notice that a guardianship case had been opened about you?
No.
Nothing in writing?
Nothing in writing. As we speak, nothing in writing.
This all started last year when Bessie says she fell 2 times and ended up in the hospital. Bessie says on her own, she arranged for in-home caregivers, but she still needed a ramp to bypass her front steps with her walker.
Without the ramp, I could not get outside to transact business.
Someone contacted Adult Protective Services for a welfare check. And then Bessie says this APS investigator named Tresna Tupper came into her home uninvited.
That's intrusion.
Court records show Tupper even wrote under penalty of perjury that she couldn't find Bessie's adult children to tell them about the guardianship, even though the 7 investigators easily found Bessie's daughter on Facebook. Legal experts say Bessie's family would have had priority under the law to become a guardian if one was needed.
Your guardian is making some very intimate decisions about everything about your life. And really, those folks who are closest to you are going to be in the best position to be able to make those decisions.
I do not need no one to oversee my finances or a guardian. I'm mentally capable of transacting my day-to-day business.
Bessie says she did not have transportation for court, so she could not attend the guardianship hearing last summer. Tupper asked the court to appoint White House Guardian Services, which is owned by Stacy White Smith. Tupper also nominated a lawyer named Cynthia Williams to be Bessie's conservator to take over her Social Security income. Williams and White Smith deny they have any sort of relationship with Tupper.
Have you met your conservator?
No, never.
On her own, Bessie contacted a local nonprofit who installed the ramp for her in August.
So the guardian did not help you get the ramp?
No.
Stacy White Smith would not talk to us on camera, but she did admit she's only seen Bessie 2 times since she was appointed guardian in June. 2 months later, the 7 investigators started asking questions about why Bessie Owens was put under guardianship. Now both the guardian and the conservator have told the court they want out of the case. But court records show the conservator wants to get paid $687.50 for 5.5 hours of work.
Ms. Williams, we'd like to talk to you about Ms. Owens.
We caught up with the conservator after a court hearing.
Why are you trying to charge her $687 when she only has $6,500?
Because that is my fee for my services.
What did you actually do, though?
It's on my account. Did you see it?
I did see your account, but you never talked to her. You never went to see her. You filed some paperwork. She doesn't have that much money. She said she doesn't need a guardian or conservator. So what did you do?
You saw my account, correct?
I did. I'm asking you what you did.
It told you. My account shows you what I did.
I want everybody to know, especially the population that I'm in, which is seniors and people with disability, what can happen if you don't pay attention by the system that's supposed to protect us.
We did try several times to talk to Tresna Tupper from APS. A spokesman says they can't comment on the specifics of this case due to privacy rules, but he says they try to provide the least restrictive services that are necessary to keep seniors safe. They are planning now additional training for workers, and they're looking into the concerns that have been raised here. We also have a statement from the Guardian at WXYZ.com, and Bessie will be in court next week. She hopes to have this guardianship lifted. Of course, we'll update you after that hearing.
So good that you're shining the light on this again.
And clearly it's needed for the protection of these seniors and families who sometimes don't know what is taking place with their loved one.
It's a very extreme step. Yeah. There have to be checks and balances along the way.
And we got to protect them. Thank you so much, Heather, as always, for your investigation.
Thank you.